Tobacco companies have been buying up vaping companies for many years, but they still can't escape the regulatory scrutiny of these products. So now they've come up with a new plan. Let's come up with a laboratory-created type of nicotine. let's do it in a test tube. It's not a tobacco product, therefore we can lie to the FDA. We don't even have to report to the FDA. If people start turning into bunny rabbits from smoking the damn vape, we don't have to worry about that. There's nothing we have to, if they show up with an extra eyeball, we have no idea what this new type of 6-methylene is going to do, do we?
No.
We have no idea. It's not even studied enough to know what the long term is, but kids are smoking it every day, and it's giving them a better buzz than regular nicotine.
Yeah, and I will actually, unfortunately, let me kind of correct you, because we kind of do know what it does, and it's horrifying.
Okay.
In rodents, the lethal dose for 6-methyl nicotine is smaller than for nicotine. Studies also showed that the new synthetic nicotine was required to increase blood pressure and behavioral responses triggered by nicotine receptor activation. The analog even bound more strongly to nicotine receptors than nicotine itself and was more toxic to airway cells.
Okay, so is this report, this part, what I call the vapors, it's insane. I mean, they'll load up the comments like, oh my God, how dare you say that? This saved me from nicotine. It saved my life. And you can give them all the information. You can say, look, it's got this chemical, and that'll cause neurological damage. It's got this chemical that will affect your heart and your lungs. It's got this chemical now that we don't even know how bad it is. And they're still going to say...
But we know it's messing with your heart, your brain, and your lungs.
Right.
You know, you kind of need all three of those to really live. But what is so crazy, because apparently, you know, Scientific American did a great job on this story.
Yeah.
And I haven't seen it anywhere else. Yeah. But they talked about the fact that this actually began, tobacco companies, once they started really being regulated in the 90s, they said, okay, the regulations specifically spell out the chemical formula for nicotine derived from tobacco products. So we got to create a synthetic. Then we can escape all the regulatory hurdles because we don't have to get it approved. Yeah. So they've been working on this for 30 years and they finally got it and they're sticking it in these little things.
Okay, they had, we brought the first tobacco.
Yep.
We initiated the tobacco litigation in this country. People may not know that, but it started with my law firm. And when we saw the documents, this was appearing in the documents back then. They were looking for something to say, the FDA is killing us. The bad press is killing us. Can we come up with something to put in there that we haven't studied? We don't know what it's going to do. And now they still haven't studied. They still don't. We know what it does to rats. We know what it does to dogs and guinea pigs. But we don't know what it does to humans long range. But we do know it has something to do with neurological, heart, respiratory. We do know that. But people watching this who are vaping are so committed to this. This thing we're talking about will have zero effect on them. I mean, literally zero effect, because they've got this wall, and the wall is, oh God, this saved my life. I stopped smoking. I'm not putting tobacco in my. You'd probably be better off with tobacco than you would this new chemical.
Well, what's interesting here about the hatred from the vapors is, you know, you think the response when we do anti-Trump stories from the MAGA freaks is bad. You think the Democratic response when we go after Democrats is bad. Nothing beats the way the vapors are. Like, they make the rest of y'all look like you don't even care about politics. That's how, like, they will come at us. We will get.
Oh, you've gotten threats. I mean,
legitimate. Like, you talked about this could kill me.
How about I kill you?
Yeah.
How about I kill you?
Like, yeah, we're just trying to actually help people and educate and inform them. This is from Scientific American. This is not coming from a partisan news outlet.
Well, moreover,
these are people that know what they're talking
about. Like I say, we brought the tobacco case in America.
Yeah.
We saw part of this story way back then. We knew what they were looking for way back then, because that was part of the defense. Part of the attack was, well, you had an alternative. You didn't even have to use a tobacco product, right? Yeah, we had this, but they had already hooked people on tobacco, on the nicotine from tobacco. So now they're hooking them on something brand new. and the FDA can't do anything about it. And the person out there vaping says, this is wonderful. I'm not worried about it because they're so friggin' brain dead that this is, sounds like a good idea to them.